me a story about how the friends crashed on a motorcycle. You know, like, why do people have to be so negative? I don't go up to pregnant women telling them my dad left. You know what I'm saying? So annoying. So annoying. I walked at my apartment one time, right? I walked at my apartment, and my neighbor walked up to me. She was like, oh my God, you got a motorcycle? Are you serious? Are you serious? You better be careful. I got in a car wreck the other day. My car flipped 8 times. I'm looking to be alive. Blessed. She black, by the way. Everyone around us was like, you know, that is crazy that your car flipped 8 times. You alive. You are blessed, you know? And I'm over here thinking, who the heck counted, right? Like, who's that car when their car's flipping in the air? I feel safe driving with my grandma because she's really spiritual. She loves the Lord to the point where she's not afraid of dying. So I don't like that, right? I don't like being in a car with someone that's not afraid of death, okay? Like, she got that attitude like, if I die, I'm going to heaven, so it don't matter. Like, it does matter, because I'm in the car, okay? This is how spiritual my grandma is. If I got shot in the chest with a gun 8 times, instead of calling the ambulance, she would get on her knees praying like, please, Lord Jesus, I get these 8 demons I found my grandbaby's chest.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. As you may be able to tell, I'm a struggling stand-up comedian who also struggles to stand up. To be honest, I'm not sure how good I am. I'll leave it for you to decide. But just so you know, if you don't laugh at the disabled guy, you are going to hell. When I realized I'd never be able to talk again, I was speechless. I have lived in Newcastle all my life. But for some reason, I still haven't picked up the accent. I can see that some of you are trying to figure out where you know me from. Maybe it would help if I started saying phrases such as, the next train to arrive on platform 4 is the 12, the 57 is the 19th cross. And, from my time at the post office, please go to cashier number 8. I got the train here today. I always like to sit in those seats for disabled people. I was about halfway here when another disabled person got on and asked me to move. I didn't realize I'd be playing disabled top trunks when I got on, or I would have dressed more special. Needless to say, I didn't give up my seat. Who cares if he was both blind and deaf? I was there first. It was very awkward. He couldn't see that I was still there. And I couldn't tell him I wasn't moving because I can't speak. Before I leave you, I have one more thing to say. I hate that we have so many politically correct words to describe disabled people now. It's all special needs, special schools, special Olympics. I don't know what is so special about me. That is why it always alarms me when I hear about special forces going to war. You've been a fantastic audience. Goodbye.
They say that breakfast is the most important meal of the day. Well, not if you're poisoned. Then the answer. antidote becomes the most important meal. I'm trying to find the woman of my dreams, but it's a struggle because I'm an insomniac. I tried online dating. There'd be people that say must love dogs. I didn't understand why. Like, I want to love a person. But it all made sense once I looked at the faces of the people that were saying that. Dating's really hard for me, like, compatibility-wise. Like, I'm a Virgo, so that means... Yeah. That means I'm only compatible with people that are really naive and believe in horoscopes. I traded my car to get my interest rates lowered. It worked. Women are less interested in me. I once had my identity stolen. It's okay, they gave it right back. Thank you.
Well, I'm at that age now where all my friends are getting married, and married people forget how horrible it is being single. They love to call me and complain about their company problems. Always get, "You are so lucky being single." I get home, my wife just starts nagging, nag, nag, nag. I'm like, "Hey, I have to nag myself." I get home, I'm like, "What time do I call this? Myself." I haven't always been a comedian. I did some weird jobs. I used to clean houses, and I'll admit I was tempted to steal. I didn't steal because the Bible says thou shalt not steal, but nowhere does it say thou shalt not swap. I took a stereo and left a Walkman. Plasma screen, left an Etch-a-Sketch. As I mentioned, I am from Africa. I moved here 10 years ago. And immediately I moved here, I heard a lot of British people talking about the financial crisis, the recession. I'm from Africa. What are you maniacs talking about? You call that a crisis? If that's a crisis, where is UNICEF? Where is Bono? You can tell me it's a financial crisis when their planes fly over Birmingham tossing fish and chips out the window. It will be a financial crisis when their ads on television saying this chav has to walk 5 miles a day to get a bottle of WKD Blue. Thank you so much, Brandon.